Hello, gorgeous humans. How are you doing today? My name is Alina Grayson, coming to you for day one of the story masterclass. I was about to say I am masterclass. The story masterclass. This is a 3-day series and it's going to be extraordinary. And I'm dedicated to your transformation. And I am so excited. When you're hopping on, say hello. Let me know if you guys can hear me well. And let me make sure I'm in the right place. Okay. And then just someone say hi in the comments so I make sure comments are working because I definitely want to talk to you guys. Also, it's 11:11. Make a wish. Okay. Let me just make sure that we're in the right spot. Okay. We're good. Oh, hello, Sherry. First one I saw. Hello, my gorgeous 101, my incredible friend. How are you? Hello, Kendall. I'm so happy that you're here. Oh, I'm so excited. Hello, Lisa. I'm so happy that you're here. So before I even get started, I want to let you guys know, hello, Shore. I'm so happy you're here, that we will be doing a tuition draw. So for everybody who shares throughout the masterclass, I will be drawing five, maybe some extra people for 50% off that you can use towards any of my programs, excluding memberships and private coaching. And masterminds, only because memberships, you already get everything half off. And there are some incredible new things coming. And I cannot wait to share that with you. But I am so excited for this masterclass. Hello, Yarn. Hello, Deanna. Hello, Rebecca. Thank you so much for tagging everybody. And then there will be a replay that I will also put on my YouTube channel as well. Okay, we're good. We're live in the right spot. Okay, I'm just gonna say hi to you guys. Perfect. Oh, hello, hello. Okay. So this is a day one, and this is going to be extraordinary. I've been working on this behind the scenes for a little while. Hello, Deanne. Hello, Hamidia. Hello, Michelle. Hello, Anastasia. If I miss you, I love you. I see you. Today, I'm going to really focus. Tomorrow, I'm going to really focus. We're going to have time also for Q&A next week. I'm going to do a tuition draw. So there's going to be so much time to pick my brain and ask questions. I want to make sure this is very streamlined. Just winding through lakes on Highway 7. Oh, that's amazing. Hello, Katie Gray. You so much. How are you? How are you? How are you? So before I even start the masterclass, I just want to say for those of you alive and with me right now, I'm so happy that you're here. For those of you watching our replay, I'm so happy that you're here. And I want to say that you're extraordinary because I cannot tell you how many people sign up for these things and they'll say, I'll watch it later and I'll do it next week and I'll do it as long as, AKA never. And this is why nothing changes. So I'm so grateful that you're here. And hashtag replay when you're watching the replay. Brandy, Monty May Live. Yay, I'm so happy that you're here. You know, intention is one thing, but showing up is a whole nother ball game. Honoring your word in life, honoring your word in business and relationships is not always easy when life happens. And I have a plot twist happening right now behind the scenes. I'll be sharing that as unravels, but of course, always plot twists. Like I manifest it. But for those of you who honor your word and you schedule replays, and you, if you can't make lives because life does happen, but you do eventually watch this, you're going places in life because this is personal power. As long as people are as long as people. But when you show up and you do it, hi, Amy, this is everything. And so it's also really normal to be really excited for day one. But who are you on day two, day three, day four, day five, day 100? If you show up for these next 3 days and whatever else I have planned next week, I promise you, you will have shifts in your life. I have been mentoring and coaching people through all walks of life and all areas of life for 5 years now. I'm actually celebrating that this month, 5 years being online. And I promise you, if you show up, if you schedule replays, you do the work, you actually listen, you actually contemplate, because I'm going to be giving you homework. Hi, Anita. Magical things will unfold for you. My identity, my life has drastically changed over the 5 years. Like, and so many things are happening behind the scenes that I can't wait to share. Congrats. I seriously, like, for those of you who know my story, like, this is like 5 years in the becoming, but I will tell you, I'm going to help you collapse time around your results. But, like, for those of you who don't know me, like, 5 years ago, massive debt, unemployed, two babies under four, like, leaving a shitty relationship, like, totally not aligned with me. In a small apartment, no support, lost depression, all the things. And I built this business from scratch. I learned how to speak online. I learned how to storytell. I found my dream man. We're engaged. We're in my dream home. We are raising four kids. I've been to published magazines. I promise you, things can shift and they can shift fast, but you gotta show up. So if you can't stay on, make sure you schedule the replays. Thank you so much. and integrate what I'm going to teach. Like, your life can drastically change, but we're not killing the old version of you. The old version's coming with you, because there are different identities we have, and we're not killing anyone off. We just want to strengthen the new identity, but you got to show up. What honestly has changed my life the most is that when life happens, even through storms and having four kids and all the things, I plug into this kind of work every single day, every single day. Because the biggest breakthrough that I've had in self-development was realizing that we do not have control of our mind. And I realized, as I started to do this work, my mind was not my mind. My mind was so distracted and completely controlled by external things. It was controlled and distracted by the news, social media, validation, what people said, what I thought people thought of me, by stress, by emotions. It was not my mind. It was guided by other people and stories and news and drama. And I didn't even know I had the power to control my own mind. Lindsay, hello, your programs are fire. Thank you. And this is like a program. I'm going to be adding things and it's going to be extraordinary. But I did not know we did not have control over mind. I did not know I was on autopilot all the time. And this is most people. Most people are so controlled by external things and so distracted. They don't even know that they have the consciousness to realize, am I actually choosing to think about what I'm thinking about? And the point of self-development is truly for us to stop being on autopilot, to actually become conscious, to actually get control of our mind, to think, what am I thinking about and what do I want to think about? Good morning, Dr. Linda. I'm so happy that you're here. This is the whole point, is to get control of our mind again, because you hear this all the time, but your thoughts create everything. They attract everything, and they literally dictate who you are as a person. Your thoughts, the way you think, what you think about, creates this frequency around you, and they change who you are. And manifestation is not about manifesting what you want. It's the understanding that you manifest who you are, what you think about on a daily basis. And your stories, the things you say about yourself, about people, the world, they create this energy around you, this frequency around you that creates also your emotions. And you know this is true because every time you're around someone that is feeling a little off, you can tell when you stand beside someone, they're thinking something not good. You can tell when somebody's in their head. You can tell when somebody's really stressed. It's not just emotions. It's their feet. It's their thoughts. It's like, what are you thinking about? I can tell by standing beside someone, someone's thinking something really weird. We feel each other's energy. Hello, Christine. Thank you for tagging Patricia. You're so freaking incredible. I love you. But we feel not just people's emotions, it's their thoughts, because your thoughts do create your emotions. And so we are constantly tapping into each other's energy. When you're feeling and thinking and stressing bad things, people can feel that. Your thoughts, your stories, they create a vortex around you. And it is felt by everybody around you, not just the universe, God, source, but people then choose to either want to be around you based on what you're thinking about, what stories you're telling, or they're choosing to be repelled by you. People feel what you feel. People think and feel what you are thinking and feeling. And the issue is most of us are not in control of our mind and we're on autopilot. And there's a new membership coming because I have realized I want to make sure that people have opportunity to come into my world at every level, whether you're going to be this membership, that's not going to be a commitment. It's going to be a low cost thing where we're going to be doing this work, whether you do inner circle with me, a mastermind, whether you do these free things with me. My purpose, my dharma is to help people evolve, to transform, to get them to where they want to go. And this is what I'm committed to. And I will be like, till on my deathbed, probably on a podcast, telling you guys, okay, with old, like, seriously, this is the goal. This is my mission. And so we are on autopilot a lot and we are dictated a lot by a lot of things. And so I want to help you really get control of your mind. And today we're really going to deep dive into your shadows. Yes, we all have shadows, things you don't even realize. We're going to start talking about your stories. Day two, we're going to reinvent you. We're going to morph. It's going to be really a rediscovery. But understand this. You don't manifest what you want. You manifest who you are. And so what you think about, what stories you tell yourself about yourself to other people, that's exactly what people fear from you. That's exactly what you're attracting. There is a frequency. Michelle's an inner circle and it's extraordinary. But I have another membership coming. There's something else coming. I have been working behind the scenes. Like I have all these graphics. I'm like, I just want to launch all of it, but all in good timing. But I want to make sure that there's something accessible for everybody. So when I am thinking about my desires, when I'm in my visionary mind, when I am thinking about my mission on the planet, and I am thinking of my desires, I'm not even kidding you. Everywhere I go, I attract people. And people, I have found clients just because I'm thinking about my vision and I'm thinking about my mission. And all of a sudden, somebody be like, "What do you do?" And I don't have a business card. So I'm like, just check me out on social media. Because if you're really going to figure me out, you're going to want to follow me on social media. But out of nowhere, people want to give me something free. It's insane. Try this next time you're out. Just start thinking about your desires, your mission, and watch how people gravitate towards you. And notice next time you're stressed and you're worrying and you're thinking about something really impending doom, people are like, ew, stay away from that person. Our thoughts create our feelings and they create a vortex of energy around us, and it's felt by everything. And so don't just watch me like a Netflix series. I want you to really lean back and listen. You can take little notes, you can put things in the comments for yourself, but I want you to come back and re-listen. I want you to actually contemplate. I'm going to give you homework. And I'm one of those very unconventional people, and I have ways to explain shadow work, and it's a fun way, but we got to look at the things that are holding us back, and we got to stop being so distracted and get control of our mind. And so this summer, I noticed, like, for people also like in business, because I work with a lot of entrepreneurs who stopped and didn't do anything and now they're worrying about money. It's like we do have to plug into this work every day. We really do. Otherwise, you're always going to be dictated by the autopilot that you're on and you don't even know what you're thinking about. Getting clients from tapping my vision, that's huge. Yes, I have so many incredible things planned for us. It's going to be amazing. So your thoughts, they don't just create a frequency. They don't just attract, they change you. They change your frequency. They really cultivate and solidify the kind of identity you have. So today we're going to start the process of really gaining control of our mind. You guys know the first key to any transformation is really awareness and really noticing. And we can't create a new identity and a life that we're happy. And I'm actually going to talk about being proud of, because the goal is really not to be happy. What we want to do is we want to wake up feeling proud of ourselves and the life that we've created, because we're not going to be happy 24/7. That is illusion. That does not happen. But we want to be proud. Even on sad days, we want to wake up and say, I'm proud. I'm proud of the person I'm becoming. I'm proud of the life that I'm creating. And for those of you who are here for more, let's go. Let's have a paradigm shift. We all have stories. We all have witnesses to our shadows, those little addictions, those little things you hate about yourself, where you feel like you're going to project onto people. But very few of us on this planet really get to tap into our genius and like that extraordinary version that we're capable of becoming in our lifetime. And honestly, I believe in this quote by Tony Robbins, hell on earth would be meeting the person that you could have been. And let's go and meet that version. Let's start that process today. You have the ability to become whoever you want. If you want more money, you want to be more charismatic, more magnetic, you want to make more impact, you want to have a greater relationship, you want to start a business, you want to become better at speaking, selling, this is going to require an identity shift. In self-development, we always hear just start changing your habits. And then we get all overwhelmed, right? All those things we should do. It doesn't work. It's the identity that we have to shift first. It all has to start in the mind. Have you guys ever heard, for those of you who might have caught my live yesterday, but I'll give a little recap here because some people won't watch it, but have you ever heard of the hero's journey? Hashtag replay. It is the stories of all stories. Like, think of all the movies. It's a hero's journey. It's The Matrix, it's Superman, it's Lion King, it's the story of all stories. And they really do follow the same story plot. There's twists, there's up and down on the way up, but ultimately, the hero story is the identity shift. You know, we think about people like Walt Disney, Tony Robbins, Oprah. It's the hero story, it is an identity shift. And there are three phases, which is why there are 3 days to this masterclass. And I'm going to show you over 3 days what is going to be required of you on your hero journey, because you are the hero of your life. There is nobody that's coming to save you. We only have guides. I want to be like the Morphosis to your Neo. I am a 6-2 human design. I am a role model. Like, I am very much here to be like the wise sage. I see things that most people don't see, and I want to be like the Morphosis, but I'm not here to save you. I really believe that the way that people are going to change their lives is to understand that they're the main character, they're the hero, and we're not mothering people into changing. And I'm not going to tell you what to do. I'm going to keep walking towards my evolution on my mission. And for those of you who want to calibrate, we're going to calibrate together. This is the goal, to be self-led, to understand you are the hero of your story. And it's got to start with really understanding our story so that we can really shift our identity to match the kind of reality and life that we are proud of. So let's begin. Of all great stories, they're all really a story of transformation. Every story starts with a call to action, a call to more. And I often, I'm going to use marketing words, even though I don't believe them. Like, I'll say things like reinvent yourself, but really it's going to be about rediscover yourself, because I really do believe you always knew who you were until people brainwashed you. But I really believe negative emotions, and there are no negative emotions. Really, what I call them is just bad feelings. That's all it is. But for marketing's sake, for things to really land, there's always a call to action. And what it all starts with is pain. It starts with a dissatisfaction in our life. Anytime that we find ourselves in life dissatisfied, bored, so we're escaping, that's part of your shadows, or we're numbing out on things. Anytime we have pain, negative emotions, it's a call to action, it's a call to shift. And so I often say, and quote unquote, negative emotions are a call to action. When you have a headache, it's a call to action. It's like, go drink water, take a nap, go for a poop, get outside, get some fresh air, put your feet on the grass. It's a call to action. When you have an ache, it's a call to action. And that is really what our negative, quote unquote, emotions are, when we have dissatisfaction, when we're really bored in life. And so it could be as simple as you just being dissatisfied. If you find yourself escaping, so there are three different phases of shadow work. There's suppression, escaping, there's projections, and I will explain those on as we go through this. But if you find yourself escaping, numbing out, drinking a lot, smoking a lot, binging a lot, scrolling a lot, involved in gossip, in drama, you are projecting on other people, even reality TV obsessions with that, that's you projecting. It's you not wanting to cast a spotlight on yourself. So it's like, hey, let's cast spotlights on other people. All of this stuff is the call to action. This is the start of your hero's journey. You are the hero of your story. And so, for those of you who know my story, I'm going to give you a little bit of context here. But my call to action was when I found myself very depressed in a very unhappy relationship. We made bad investments, in debt, like completely loss of my purpose. If you have a six line in your human design, we go through a lot of phases of like all over the place, right? So there was anxiety, there was a wrong relationship, there was debt, there was lost in purpose. And most of us, that's how we kind of end up in self-development, right? We want to help ourselves. It was the call to action. So yesterday I talked about this on a live, and I want to just give this context here because it's an important part of this series. Yes, I love how you call forward what we all need to hear. Yes, I want to be really real with you in the most compassionate, amazing way. I have this gift. It's a gift of foresight, but in a way of like, I'm going to tell you the truth because I'm dedicated to you shifting your life. Sometimes it hurts, but it's the realism that we need. We have way too many yes people in our life, and I want to be real with you because I want you to evolve. So all of us usually start in self-development because there's a call to action. We're dissatisfied. We want something more. We want to change things. There's pain. And so here's the thing with self-development is a lot of people who get in self-development, they really just focus on the one part, which is all about the self-improvement. It's the like, let me just add new belief systems, 6-3, you definitely know. That three line is all over the place. So there's self-improvement, and that's where most people focus on the most, right? The new habits. Let me just add new habits, new ways of thinking, belief codes, But a lot of people are forgetting to do the most important part. And this is why we can't take off, is doing the shadow work, really looking at where we're projecting. Why are we projecting? Why are we suppressing? Why do we, like, you know, escape things, you know? And so I want to put a little light on your shadows. We all have them. And I'm going to be very raw and real with you. And the more you're in my world, I'll tell you all the things I've done and all the mistakes, no shame and guilt, because we all have this within ourselves. So I want to put a spotlight on that, because we don't do this part enough. We just want to add habits and think that we're going to miraculously change. But there are stories you tell yourself. There are shame and guilt. There is shadows. There's the releasing part of self-development we don't do enough of. And there's this self-acceptance that we need to do. And there's obviously forgiveness and all that, but we don't do a lot of self-acceptance, and we don't really do a lot of, like, really looking at our shadows. Callie says, I needed this conversation today. I'm so happy. And if you feel like someone should be here and hear this, please add them to the group, share. I will put this on my YouTube channel as well. I know not everybody does the Facebook thing, so it will be accessible. So self-improvement, and this is the analogy I gave yesterday, and I have so many analogies. I'm bringing props on day three. You're going to laugh, but it's going to be incredible, because I do believe we learn differently. Some of us are very visual. Some of us are very, like, I need to see it. I need to hear it. I need to touch it. So self-improvement is like a hot air balloon, right? So when they're putting the hot air balloon up in the air, they have the fire, right? They're blowing it into the hot air balloon. This is how I look at self-improvement, self-development. It's like we're adding all the beliefs, we're adding the identities, we're adding the new habits, right? But then a lot of people are not soaring up into the sky, and they're not taking off, because there are sandbags attached to the hot air balloon. And so because we don't do the self-acceptance, the releasing work, the shadow work, we can't take off. Tomorrow, we begin the whole adventure of reinventing yourself. And I have some incredible things for you to think about who you really, really want to be. And it's going to be awesome. And I'll give you tactical strategies, which is great. But lasting change is an identity shift. And this comes from James Clear, Automatic Habits, amazing book. And the issue with people in self-development is they're just doing the self-improvement, adding the habits. And we hear this a lot. Just change your habits, change your life. Actually, I'm going to be very unconventional with you. That doesn't really work. We got to start with the stories. We got to look at the shadows. We got to do some releasing and a lot of self-acceptance. But I will tell you, there's nothing wrong with you. You're freaking incredible. You have just been hardwired like a computer with a virus from other people's stuff and distracted, because this world is built to make us very, very distracted. Thank you guys for tagging. You guys are incredible. But there's nothing wrong with you. We just have to fix the stories. That's it. We got to fix the stories. We got to shift the identity. And then once you shift your identity, the habits are automatic. I love that book, 1% Better Each Day. Yes, yes, yes. Right. And so what I have found to be true with working with clients, and I've worked with clients on everything, not just business, like, you know, the eating disorders, you know, all kinds of addictions, like all kinds of things from all kinds of walks of life, body image, you know, and honestly, it's the stories. It's the stories we got to change. It's the identity we have to shift. It's not what you normally hear, but this is what the goal. And so when you change your stories and you shift your identity, you're going to just automatically change your habits, the way that you respond, right? Like, I have this identity of a mentor. It's something that lives within me. I have this role model frequency. So it's like the older version that's in there, because that inner child is in there, like that part doesn't respond anymore. It's there. You know, a lot of people in trauma work will say, you got to heal everything. And this is an identity, to think that you're got to be healing all the time. If you're always in the identity of I'm healing, you're always going to be looking for things to fix. I don't believe we can heal everything. We're going to have scars, and you are going to get triggered in life. But the goal of this, and I do a lot of this in Goddess Cult, is just to not allow the wounded part of us, the one that has the tantrum, to lead the show anymore. She's going to pop up. She's going to pop up. You're going to get triggered. It's going to bring you back. But the awareness of, like, I'm going to choose to respond differently is ultimately what changes our life. You change the way you respond, everything around you responds differently. And so we're going to change your identity. We're going to look at your stories. And then you just start changing who you are and how you respond and your habits. And it's all going to be a byproduct of this new identity. Behaviors always follow the story, the identity that we have, right? So James Clear says, all lasting change is a shift in identity, and is an identity shift. And that is really transcending your limiting stories and the viruses, because I like to look at the brain as like a computer software. We're going to be upgrading things in there, but we got to transcend the limiting stories. And over the next 3 days, that's what we're going to do. You know, the goal is not to give up smoking or cut down. The goal is to become a non-smoker. The goal isn't to, I want to run 10K, I want to squat 100 pounds. It's, I am fit. It's not, the goal isn't, I want to learn how to write a book or like, I want to, you know, write. It's, I am a writer. I am a speaker. When you start living your life through that lens, identity, and for those of you in the I Am Masterclass, like this is where we have to start. And so it's got to be, I am a role model. I am a mentor. I am a speaker. This, then we start acting, feeling, and becoming more aware of how we actually act. Then we start changing our stories and we start changing everything. Hello, Betty. I'm so happy you're here. Because the story that you're living right now, it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. It is your creation. Although, you know, a lot of people have a hard time accepting this because it's like, well, I didn't choose this. You're right. You didn't. Most of the stuff that you are responding from, the habits, the stories you're telling yourself that's creating the self-fulfilling prophecy, it wasn't a conscious choice. You know, if you've been in the self-development work, we know that we are not conscious from the ages about 0 to 7. Some people say almost to 12, but you are in a theta state. It's the subconscious state. You're a sponge. This is how we kind of survive in the world, to mimic the people around us. We are programmed by our parents, our teachers, our caregivers, the news, media, whatever culture you're from. We take on the habits, the behaviors, the programming, the defense mechanisms. Like these are all learned behaviors. So yes, it is your fault right now that you have the life that you have, although you didn't choose it. But now that we are adults and we are conscious and we're here, we have the choice. And something I learned on my journey too as well, and I never really understood this for a little while, but if it is in your body, it is in your lineage. If it's in your lineage, it's in your body. What does this mean? This means that our cells, when we are in our mom and she goes through trauma, and if your grandma carried your mom and she went through war and she went through trauma, those cells live within you. Those cells are in your body. And so they are also part of the way you respond. This is why some people can't remember if they have had trauma, but they have trauma responses. It's because if it's in your lineage, it's in your body. Those cells are carried with you. So a lot of things to contemplate. And so, yes, right now, it's your responsibility. You are free, which means you are responsible for how the rest of your story goes. Your identity, your story, your reality, it's not set in stone. Just like your brain is not, like, you know, they say, can't teach a dog old tricks. And they used to say that your brain, once you're 30, it stops growing. But the only reason we say that is because by the time we're 30, we stop learning. And that's the issue. But neuroplasticity proves we can continue to grow new neurons and fire new neuron pathways. The only reason we say that people are just haven't changed is who you are by the time you're 30 is only because we stop learning. I hope that you become the kind of person that picks up a book once a month or does program or does Inner Circle or does this new membership that I'm going to be offering at a very low cost, no commitment thing. Because if you're learning, you're constantly upgrading your hardware. It's the moment we stop learning new things, then we just fall back onto who we've been. And then we feel like we're set in stone. And a lot of us have school trauma. So that's another thing. We're like, oh, don't learn anymore. Learn. I know school is not meant for all of us, but it's important that you're learning and you're growing and you're creating new neurons. Inner Circle is the best. Thank you. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited. And there's so many things coming. If you do Inner Circle, you get everything that I create apart from mentorship, but I will be adding mastermind calls in Inner Circle. There's things coming. I'm so dedicated to this mission. So I think the issue with the world too, is we have stopped learning and we have forgotten that we are responsible for the creation of our life. And like I said, at the beginning of this call, the biggest issue is that we are very distracted and we are very brainwashed. And this world is very built on making us distracted. And a lot of people, they're bored. Inner Circle is incredible. Thank you, Jessica. I love you guys so much. But a lot of people are bored. And the reason we're bored is we've forgotten that we're supposed to evolve and grow and learn. This is what brings you fulfillment. This is why success is such a moving target. Like you hit your success and you're right on to the next thing. But really what makes us so proud, so happy, so fulfilled is our evolution, when we're changing, when we're growing, when we're like, whoa, I used to be this way, now I respond this way. This is what we need. So people are bored and they're not in control of their mind. They're very distracted and their spirits are on the back burner and they have settled. And there are meaningless things like gossip, celebrity, Netflix, numbing out on junk food, drinking every day, causing their own dramas. And you know that we are supposed to feel alive, which is the whole feeling of growth and evolving and learning. Because the reason, and people always ask me, why do we sabotage? You sabotage because you're bored, because you're not working towards anything. This is where humans' fulfillment comes from. This is why we will like, hey, let me just go throw a wrench in my relationship and start some drama so then someone can chase me around and I can feel like I'm being loved again. We do this all the time because we want to feel alive, you know? And so we have forgotten that it is our responsibility to come alive. And we don't need to sabotage. We get to choose to do self-development work. I want to work on my focus. I get distracted lately. Okay, I got you. I got you. I got so many strategies and tools for you guys. It's going to be incredible. But not from, here's the thing, like I don't create programs and I don't do self-development because there's something wrong with me. And I don't create programs because there's something wrong with you. I don't do it for healing. I really do believe like trauma is really like, if you have like every morning you wake up with a dysregulated nervous system because something traumatic has happened, like this is where therapy is. But coaching is really like, let's look at it. Let's release it. Let's shift it. Let's, you know, look at it as it happened for me. It grew me. And now what? And now we choose to grow and evolve and continue our story. Coaching is, that's what that's for. You know, if you have trauma and you're very dysregulating nervous system, that's when you go for therapy. But program self-development, it's not intended because there's something wrong with you and you need to be healing. That's an identity. For those of you trapped in like, I just need to heal. It's also become an excuse for a lot of people. I just got to heal until I can heal. It's like, that's your identity. And you'll keep looking for problems to fix. We're never going to be perfect. The goal is to constantly be just growing and evolving. But I don't create programs and I don't do self-development because there's something wrong with me. There's something wrong with you. It's just that like, it's the desire for more. What else am I capable of? I'm on this planet for a reason during this time. It's sacred. Like the fact that we're all here, you know, some of your grandparents, like I'm Polish, like I'm a first generation immigrant. My whole family went through war and all kinds of things. And I am here. Like it's insane. There's a reason, there's a purpose. And so I create programs because I want you to grow and evolve with me and let's create fulfillment and let's go figure out what we're meant to do with this beautiful one life. And let's go see what we're capable of because that's where ultimate happiness comes from. That's where that feeling of like, I wake up proud because I'm doing something. I'm moving something. I'm shifting something. Every time you hit something, you're going to want something else. That's normal. Humans are supposed to just want more and to be, do have more. That's the goal. I really do believe also God, universe wants us to experience everything we've ever desired. This is the human. This is why our spirit chose this human life. Let me go see. Let me go do. There's nothing wrong with that. So yes, there is a piece where we do got to look at our shadow and we do got to do some forgiveness and some self-acceptance and, you know, some part of healing. You know, we do have wounds, but like I said, it's not from a place of like, oh, I'm never going to be triggered again. You know, you're still going to get things that come up, but the goal is to notice, oh, I'm triggered. There she is, that version of me, but I'm going to choose not to respond this way. I'm going to choose the goddess. I'm going to choose the mentor identity. And we're going to choose that higher version of ourselves. This is the goal, you know? And there is this old parable. I'm going to bring lots of cool analogies for you guys, but there's an old parable and it's an old native story. And it's, I'll give you the short little details of it, but it goes like this. There are two wolves fighting. And the boy asks the grandpa, like, oh, who is the wolf that's going to win? Who is the wolf that's going to win? And the grandpa says, the one that you feed. And what I love about this parable is that even though we have a shadow, even though we have this part of us that makes us feel ashamed, the triggered version of us that has an adult tantrum, that's that second wolf. It's the shadow. But ultimately, what determines who you are is the one that you constantly feed. And the one that I hope that you feed is this identity, this higher version of you, this mentor, this leader version of you, the goddess, My goal, like even in Goddess Code, is like we're not feeding into the wounded inner child. It's there, it's coming with you, you know, but we're gonna strengthen and feed the higher version of us, the one who is going to choose to respond in a different way, the one who has emotional intelligence. And Goddess Code is coming in October because I have some other things I'm gonna be launching. If you wanna do like that work, emotional intelligence, and tap into that version of you, it's gonna be an extraordinary program. It's like literally who I am, plus the coach identity. But we're just not going to feed the wounded part. We're not going to do the old defense mechanism like silent treatment. We're going to feed the new identity. And I'm going to give you tools and strategies for tomorrow on how to do that, you know? So here's some limiting stories. So let's talk about your stories because the first step is we really got to bring awareness. Okay. If we're going to change anything, we got to know what it is that is really holding us back, the limitations. So a lot of people have had the story of like, well, it's too late for me because I'm too old. A lot of people literally think by the time they're 30, their life is over. Like by the time they're 40, my life is over. Like this is one of your stories. Feel into that. Because I have had people in their 40s, in their 50s, in their 60s, even in their 70s do programs with me. And they're like, I'm so happy I did this. At the same time, saying, I wish I started earlier. But hey, now I get to pass this down on my grandkids, which is incredible. Right. But there's a story. Let me know, hashtag replay. Do you have a story of thinking it's too late? You're too old? Because let's start shifting these stories. So, what are your current stories? If you were to say, I want to be, do have, blah, 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 whatever it is. What are the things that come up for you? Because you cannot change what we're not aware of. You know, and I think is it Carl Jung that says, once you make the subconscious, it's no longer subconscious. Now it's like conscious, because then we have a choice, which is incredible. And you can't ignore it unless you're choosing to. But if you're here, you're being called for more. And so if there's pain or dissatisfaction, if you're feeling called to do something, to start a business, to whatever it is, what are the stories? My story is I'm too old. I can't pay the pretty tax. I'm too fat. Okay. Right. So, what are like, I desire to be, I desire to do, I desire to have. Like, this is what happens on the hero journey. And if you actually watch like all movies, it's like they're being called to action, right? It's like Superman, it's like Neo, right? And it's like, okay, I'm going to do it. But then it's like, the resistance starts to happen in the comfort zone. It's like, I don't want to be in this pain. I don't want to be in this satisfaction. I'm feeling called. But then we get the pushback, the stories, the limitations. And a lot of them are strong because you do have evidence. But this is where we got to start validating it and starting to find new evidence. My body story is very limiting. My body is just difficult, has no energy, has pain, can't lose weight, et cetera. Okay. So just share, guys. I want you guys to be vulnerable. I have your back. We're just bringing awareness. So don't start getting overwhelmed because a lot of people, hey, Danny, yeah, my stories, I can be, do, have anything I want, negative, sabotage. Okay. Okay. So just start noticing them. This is great. And I'm going to give you contemplation homework and stuff for you guys to look at your shadows. Okay. But the goal is not, I'm strong enough to hold their people's healing as a coach. Am I smart enough to do this? Okay, cool. I love these, right? So things like I can't because I'm too old, I'm too young, I'm too shy, I can't speak English, I'm a single mom, the economy. Even think about what you're saying about the economy, right? Because a lot of people are like, people aren't buying, people are buying. People are buying my programs, they're buying my mentors' programs, people are buying. It's like, again, we have a story. And so when you have a story of it's the economy and people aren't buying, you don't take action. The way you take action is different. It's not about what you do, it's about who you are when you do it. So when you're going out selling, but you think no one's buying, that's what's shifting it. I can't make a decision. Okay, keep sharing. If I'm missing things, just I want you guys to get it out. This is for you, but we're not shifting anything today. We are just bringing awareness. Because one of the things that gives us all overwhelmed is like, oh my God, I have all these problems and I got to shift everything at once. And that's where it's like step one, awareness. I can never have the body of my dream. It's too difficult. It's a lot of work. I'm too tired. I'm too exhausted. Oh, if you ever have a chance to do body code and there's things coming, nobody buys, it's me. Okay. I can't. Who has the identity of it's too hard? I'm not confident enough. I'm not beautiful enough. I'm not good with money. I don't have the network. I can't speak. No one in my family has ever done it. I can't, da, 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 da. No matter what I write in content. Okay. So no matter what it is that you desire to be, you do have, whether it's to change your body, these stories here, these are the things that are limiting you. This is it, guys. And so this is just important to just bring focus to it. Like, it's always hard for me. There's not enough. The economy, someone's already doing it. It's, oh, who has a story of like, this is the way I've always been. It's too late for me. These are your limitations. These are your identities. This is what you live in. And the thing is with stories is we create the energetic match for the exact storyline. Overwhelmed, where to start? I can't be present in my life with the MLM. Okay. Good thing you're in my life, guys, because this is why I'm here to be a role model. I do very things unconventionally and very efficient because, like, I do the four kids. I had to navigate my business. I'm always getting tested so I can tell you how to do it. I'm already too depleted. Okay. So pay attention. Just notice and listen to other people's stuff. Okay. Like, who has the identity of, like, here's one, I'm a warrior. That identity will always attract for things for you to fight for. You know, when you say things are always hard for you, you will create those storylines because that's your identity. And you're always going to find more evidence, which is then going to validate the stories even more. But here's the thing, even with evidence of any of these limitations, they do not make it set in stone. They do not define you. Every hero's journey, this is the thing that stops them for a second. It's the stories. Like, think about even Oprah. Like, you know, you're not going to be on TV. Meryl Streep, you're never going to sing. You can't do this. Like, they had people telling them they couldn't, and they defied the odds. You can defy the odds. Every limiting story you have, you can defy the odds. We're going to go on this beautiful journey, but just start becoming aware. Get it all out. What other stories are you creating? Let it go. And you can start putting them down and choosing. Instead of it has to be hard, it gets to be easy. Okay, because we're going to have some plot twists. We get to rewrite our script. I'm a first generation immigrant. Okay. No one in my family has even made over 30, 40K. Okay. So I didn't have any evidence of that. Okay. I struggled in school. Like, I was in ESL for a while, like, because I was like 5 and a half when I came here. And my brother was a good athlete, super confident, super charismatic. I was so shy. Permit here, okay. I obviously had to go in ESL, which made you feel like you already were different than everybody else. I wasn't particularly good at sports. The only thing I was good at was like art. I love to sketch, I love to draw. I didn't have straight A's, like, you know what I mean? Like, I struggled so much at elementary school. Like, there was no way I even thought that I would even make it through high school. Like, I wasn't athletic, I wasn't the popular one, I didn't have a lot of friends. These are true things. These were stories backed by evidence. So, of course, I was believing them. I was shy. I was awkward. Also, if you're aligned to in human design, hermits, right? Like, there's all this stuff. But this is what made me think of this whole masterclass. And then just my evolution over the last 5 years is that I remember, so elementary school, like, struggles, like, shy, like, had like one friend, Aaron. And I remember going into high school, sitting on the bus in grade 9. I don't know why this popped into my head, but I was like, I'm done. I'm just like done being the shy. I'm done with the story of being a shy kid. I literally remember this to a T, sitting there, just like, I don't want to be the shy girl anymore. I don't want to be the unpopular one anymore. And I want to be the one that gets good grades. I want to have friends. I want to be confident. And on that bus, grade 9, going to high school, I was like, I'm just going to be brave and just sit with people and talk to everybody. And that's literally what I did because I was like, I'm just so sick of being the odd one. And I just said, I'm going to be confident. And so I went and I was red in the face, but every person I sat beside the people in the lunchroom and I just started talking to them and I just started to embody, I'm confident. And that's it. And then I worked my ass off to get good grades so that I could get into university. And yeah, I worked my ass off in university. I had to also work to get there. And I got a post grad in like psychology, but like, it was not easy for me. For those of you in human design, I'm a Manny Gen. I lost focus a lot. I'm like, what's that? something over there. Like, you know what I mean? Open head, open mind. I could study sometimes and sit and totally everything just escaped me. But now I know the way I am, and I'm very unconventional. The work that I do on the planet, I realize why certain things in school did not land, because I was like, and this wasn't for me. But I did focus on some things like psych, philosophy, business. You know, I feel this, you're not alone, right? So good, guys. I hope that you guys build a community. Like, seriously, like, we all have stories, but they all happen for you. And so I gave myself literally shingles in when I was like 25 years old, which is like something you get if you're 65. And I gave it to myself because I was hustling and setting my ass off, like, you know what I mean, trying to get through university. And then I achieved the mainstream successful things that I thought would make me happy. But then, you know, then I pivoted again, the three line and the six line. I'm like, all right, what's the next thing? Like, always, like, you know, if you're a six line, you're into human design, you know, we're just like constantly new careers, new things, never finding our purpose. But now I realize everything happened for me. It is all part of my story. It's why I'm here. It's why I believe in you. And it's why I have no fear in you. I literally would also miss marks in school because I would not want to like stand up and speak in front of the class. That's one thing I just could not overcome in all of my high school and university degree. Like, so fast forward into like I'm 29 and I hit another rut and I didn't get this dream job that I was working for. I hated my corporate job. And so I moved back home and, you know, some of you know my story is so depleted, not at all in my power. I fell for the wrong person, the wrong partner, totally ignored the red flags, as we all do. But we also, as females, especially if you're spiritual ladies, we're all like, we'll be the one to fix them. No, we do not need projects, ladies. Okay, tell your ladies, tell your nieces, tell your little girls, anyone around you, we want partners, not projects. But we all do this, right? So I ignored the red flags, fell for the wrong person, got pregnant again, made bad investments, a lot of debt, very unhappy, everything fell apart. So, negative emotions again called me into action. This is why I fell into self-development work. I fell into manifestation. It was the first time, and I was like 30 years, 31, maybe 32. Yeah, around there. I didn't even know what the heck law of attraction was, right? A very logical, corporate-minded person. And I just jumped in and I started practicing gratitude and I started practicing little things like subconscious reprogramming. And I started to feel better. And, you know, not so lost, right? And I just started sharing things online. I started a fitness account, did the MLM for USANA, but I was still unhappy because I was in this relationship that was wrong. I was very stuck, especially if you're a woman and you're not working and it's like, you know, you're already in debt. It's like, how do you leave? But I was like, I had two little girls. I'm like, I want to make sure I role model the best for them. And so I one day saw someone from my high school, the power of expanders. We'll talk a little bit about that tomorrow, but I saw someone in my high school, you know, leaving her job to be a life coach online. I was like, what is a life coach online? And then I went down the rabbit hole. It was like 2017. I didn't even know what that was the thing, because I was thinking, I'm like, oh my God, I'll just go back to school and get my master's, because I always loved psychology, right? It's a 6'2" in me. Like, I always want to help people. And of course, the call to action. I'm like, oh my God, I want to do this. I want to be a life coach online. And then, of course, the limiting stories crept in, right? Backed by evidence. I have no money. I have no support, right? I lost my father. It was just my mom, right? There was nothing. Like, I had student debt too. And I'm like, how am I going to go on a live stream? How am I going to run programs? Like, I was literally still the person that would drop 20% of my grade because I just did not want to stand up in front of a class and do a presentation. So I'm like, how the hell am I going to do this business? How am I going to go live? I'm going to run programs. No, and no one made six figures in my family. Like, I sucked at this, blah, blah, blah. All the stories you have, imposter syndrome. Oh my gosh, right? Who am I to do this? And I also had the limiting story of like, I'm only like 33. Like, can I be a life coach? You know? So, and then I remembered that transition from elementary school, how much of an identity shift that I had into high school and so on. And I was like, I have to, like, and I, in those, my little two girls, I think about this all the time. That's what I kept thinking about. I have two little girls, right? Like, they're looking up to me. Is this what I want to role model for them, to be in a happy relationship, to be lost? I was like, no, I'm gonna do this. What else do I have to lose? I realize the things that I'm learning right now, they're helping me. Like, I'm gonna do this.
I'm going to be, I will be. For those of you in the I Am Masterclass, I will be an extraordinary coach. I will be on this journey. I'm going on a journey of building my coaching business. I am going to. And I started with this identity. It was like, I am going on the journey. Sometimes it's hard to say, I am dot, dot, dot. But if we can say, I'm on the journey of becoming this, I'm on the journey of becoming an extraordinary coach. Then I mastered up all my courage. And I pushed through those limiting stories. And the habits started to follow. I left my partner. I took the little bit of money I had, right? Because I got the little tiny shitty apartment, got the bed, couch. Like there was nothing in my apartment. I still have a video of it. I'm like, oh my God, but look where I am. We get to shift, guys. I promise. That's why I have no fear for you. And so I left and I had no support because I don't have much family, right? My father passed. My brothers went through a lot of things, right? My mom's still working, right? So I said, 3, 2, 1, I'm going live. Like, what else do I have to lose? Like, what's the worst that could happen? I'm not obviously going to end up on the street. If I have to go find a shitty job, I will, right? I went and took out a loan for $10,000. I invested in one program for $1,000, which was huge for me. Then I invested into another coach and another coach and their programs. I kept going live. It was like 2, 3 minutes, red in the face. I got my first client, $111. It was $888 a month. Her name's Serena. She stayed with me for years. And I just watched her get married. And she also was on the back end. Like, it's just extraordinary to also watch now some of my mentors that have been with me for 5 years and how much they have shifted. This work is profound, but it's so important you stay in it. So I got that client. Then I started to just kept going live. And then I hired a business coach, you know, it was the wrong one, lesson learned, whatever, you know, but I kept going live and I kept posting and I got another client. Then I had 3 clients and then people were like, how are you getting clients? And I was like, I'm doing my first program. I had 5 people join Magnetic Mind. Let me know if you guys were in that program. I launched that 3 times, first time 5, then it was like 7 people, then like 10 people. Then people start asking me like, and I'm a responder as a manager. And hey, how are you getting people? Because obviously I never did a sales call, no sales ads. It was just PayPal link and going live, right? And in my second year of business, I hit 6 figures. No one in my family has ever done that. And no website, no sales calls, just courage, just sharing the things that were really helping me. And sometimes I'd be like, you guys go read this book. But people are like, the way you say it is different. And that's why I know for some of you, even though you think like imposter syndrome, like why don't people just read this book or do this program? The thing is we're all unique in how we say things. The way we explain things is unique. People have read certain books where they know what I'm talking about, but the way I say it is what makes it land for them. That's why for those of you who have that imposter syndrome to be a coach, the way you are, though your story, though your unique tone, your voice, it's meant for somebody, you know? So I built a 6-figure brand and it just has been growing and there's been mistakes and there's been failures. There's been all the things, but I have been learning and I have not stopped and I have not stopped investing. In 5 years, I have not been in a program or a mastermind or had a coach. It, like, even though I believe that I'm solid, I don't need a coach. I just think it's so incredible to calibrate with people and walk with people. And when you're plugged in, for those of you, like, you know, if you're struggling with sales, if you're in programs where people are selling and you're around people, trust me, you will believe the economy is moving. It is moving. It's just that we don't plug into this stuff. This is why I'm always saying, be brave. It's like been on my phone forever. Be brave. That's how I got here. It's how I continue to grow. Life comes, but it's like, let's keep moving. Like now I'm with my partner. We have 4 kids navigating it all, running masterminds, programs. Like, I can't believe how much I do now, but even a year ago, it would take me like months to create a program. And I would do 1 live once a week. Now I do masterminds. I can do 3 days in a row, 5 days in a row. We grow, we evolve, we get better. So you have stories and they are holding you back and they are backed by evidence. I had them too, but they're not who you're going to become. It's just who you've been, but it's not who you get to become. And tomorrow I'm going to help you really tap into like, what is this identity? What is this purpose? I really will help you with that. I'll help you with strategies to help you reinvent yourself. But for today's call, you just got to start bringing awareness to your stories. Our thoughts, our stories create frequencies. That's why I love being in programs, free and paid, getting to watch, listen, right? Join the conversation, right? Even if things I'm saying that you've heard before, it's the remembrance. I'm not here to tell you something you would never know. I'm sure you will hear new things from me, but it's like every time something hits you with a truth, it's a reminder. our goal is to be conscious, like to remind ourselves of what am I thinking about? Because this is creating a vortex around me, not just in the universe with what I'm tracking, but people are either magnetized to you, repelled by you based on what you're thinking. So you get to become anything you want. You really do, but you got to get out of your own way. You got to look at what are my stories, even though I have evidence. What's the stories you're telling yourself? Awareness is step one. I can't be because dot, dot, dot. I don't have a defied will. I'm a projector. I'm too, like, it's too late. I'm too shy. I'm a single mom. It's hard. No one's done in my family. Look at those stories. What are you living out right now? And start to put them down. And you can do the whole reframe thing, but I don't really want to get into like strategies right now. But you can say like, it's been hard, but now it gets to be easy. You know, like, you got to stop validating who you've been, because it's not who you get to become. So essential to have a coach. Love that you are a coach. Me too. I'm so happy. Dr. Linda's been doing some amazing courses with me too. Like, guys, like, it, things change. And every story you know about every remarkable human, they had the same stuff. They had no help. They had the debt. They had the bankruptcy. They had the thing. Like, let's go. You can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. That's why I have no fear for you. But we got to look at, and so here's some other things I want you guys to look at. Where are you blaming? That's also an identity we have, and which usually turns into an excuse. Where are you blaming? Where are you blaming? Because that's where you're leaking your power. Where are you saying things like, the reason I can't, Alina, is because of this. The reason I can't is because of that. That identity keeps you so stuck, and it leaks your personal power. Every time you blame the economy, you now are not able to change because you're stuck in the identity of, I have no power. I'm a victim. You got to take your power. You got to take it. Like, it's got to be like, even though this happened, it happened for me. Now what do I want to do about this? What do I want to think about next? What's the rest of my story going to be about? Everything happens for us. Blame is one of the biggest identities, also excuses, where we really get stuck in victimhood. And how can you change if it's always somebody else's fault? How can you change if it's always the economy and the world, when the truth is, like, if you actually start to think that we live in an abundant world, people are buying and selling, you'll start to find it. I'll give you a cool manifestation perspective tomorrow, but it's like, when you have this identity, trust me, your mind, your RAS and your brain will literally continue to show you evidence of it until you start seeing people buy. Then you're like, people are buying. And then when you go to sell, who you are changes. And then the sales come in. It's not what you do. It's who you are when you're doing it. And so it's also the thoughts and the stories you have is why things are not working. But I believe everything happens for us. Like, every story, every mistake, this is what has helped me become an extraordinary coach. Because it's like, I got you. Oh yeah, you went through this. Let me tell you how I went through that. Oh, I went through this. Let me tell you how I went through this. Absolutely. Me trying to navigate raising capital for my business has really tested me. You got to keep going. You got to believe. People are buying. People are selling. It is. It's happening. You start focusing on abundance. You start changing the way you perceive things. You'll start finding evidence. It's wild what starts to happen. But everything that was hard for you, it made you stronger. And a lot of you, and I know I attract a lot of like leaders, 4-6s, 5-1s. Like, I attract so many leaders in my world. It's insane. And all of them have had hard things, because how can you help somebody else if you have not gone through things? Would you really hire a coach that's like, my life is perfect, nothing's ever happened? No, you're going to hire the person that's like, I've been through this, I've done that, I've had this. It's because they've led themselves and now they can support you. We don't hire people when they've gone through nothing. You're a leader, you're a coach, you're a mentor, you're a role model. There's a reason those things happen for you. How can you get people across the bridge if you've never crossed the bridge yourself? This is our work. And one day, and you got to think about it this way, even those hard, horrible things that have happened, I don't deny you've been through stuff, but what if one day you're the person up on stage helping the world shift through that? What if one day you write a book that's a bestseller helping other people through that? Nothing happens for no reason. It all happens for us. And for some of you, you ask for big things. You ask to lead people. You're going to get tested. You are. So who here also has the story of like, it's hard for me. It's hard for me to lose weight. It's hard to start a business. It's hard to make money. This is another huge identity people get stuck in, and it creates a lot of resistance for ourselves. This is literally creates a self-fulfilling prophecy where we constantly attract the storylines of hard things. And the reason a lot of people have this is because mainstream conditioning, for me. Mainstream conditioning tells us that achievements are only valuable if you worked really hard for them, if you've gone through some sort of struggle. But again, your story, your identity, things are hard for me, you valuing things that are hard are an energetic match for that exact storyline. We create our own resistance. And yes, sometimes things are hard, but they also get to be easy. And if they're hard, we're just being tested and you just got to prove it. But people have a lot of beliefs. I know, I've been in industry for 5 years. I had the same one. A lot of times, have you ever noticed, and just notice if this has happened to you, you actually achieved something. It wasn't actually that hard, but then you felt when you wanted to go celebrate it and tell a story about it, you felt like it would be more valuable to tell people a story with an elaboration about how hard it was, even if it wasn't. A lot of people do this. I used to do this too. Because you're like, this celebration and this achievement will sound better if it was hard. So let me tell it this way. And then every time you do that, you're literally casting out more seeds of like, let me keep attracting hard things into my life. If you want things to be easier, you want more flow, start telling yourself that it actually does get to be easy. But if it is hard, I'm here to be tested so I can learn, so I can help other people, and then I'm just going to prove it. But once I've gone through it, it gets to be easier. This used to be so hard for me to show up and to teach and like prep for my things. It was so hard. Oh my gosh. I was like, how do people do it? How are people like launching things all the time? Look where I've gotten myself, because I just have not given up. And now it does get to be easy. So we do get annoyed when people are like, oh, it's easy. Yeah, for you. But it's like, how do you think it became easy? I compounded it. I never gave up. I kept learning. I keep growing. I keep pushing myself. It gets to be easy, but sometimes, yeah, you'll have a little hard thing pop up. So prove it. You can change your mind around this. You can change the story. It gets to be easy, but even if it's hard, it's okay, because I'm going to learn something and it will make my success easier later on. We get to become better at this. Who here, I'm going to catch the comments later, guys, but who here, I just want you to bring noticing to these stories. Who here has the story of, but it's going to take a long time. It will take a long time. So let's give an example of debt. Who has this story? It's going to take a long time paying off debt. Here's an awesome example. So you can use this towards anything. A lot of people have this story about it's going to take a long time, especially if you have debt. It's going to take a long time. And based on last time and evidence, it's predictable that for me, based on how long it took me last time to pay it off, it's going to take this long. So based on this, it's going to take this. So this is how we actually make things long for us, because we decide it's going to take a long time. And here's the thing. The moment you tell yourself a story and you look at the past evidence and it's going to take a long time, it's that identity makes you act, not even just the way you're thinking, you're attracting it, but literally we act differently. Like if you showed up to sell something and you literally deep down did not believe people are going to buy because people are not buying right now or something like that, the way you speak, the way you show up is so different than when you believe in your conviction and you're like, people are buying, they are buying. Look at her. Look at her. I believe in this. It's who we are that changes it because of what story we have. So when you say it's going to take a long time for me to pay off this debt, enter your timeline, that story impacts your identity. The way you behave, you're slower. You don't move as fast. You don't take action in alignment with the identity. You take action in alignment with the identity of it's going to take a long time. And then you create just that. You impact it yourself. The more you believe in a story of like it's going to take a long time, it's not even just the thoughts, it's the way you're behaving that's going to take it forever. And here's another thing. Let's talk about debt for instance, right? It's going to take a long time. I'm in debt. It's like when you look at your money and you feel shame and guilt and disappointment, how much you owe and how long it's going to take, you live in that frequency. What do you think the energetic match for the frequency is of shame, guilt, and disappointment? We are constantly an energetic match for those kind of people in that frequency. If you're in business and you have shame and guilt around your money and disappointment, do you know who you attract? The same kind of people who also face shame and guilt and disappointment, who don't know how they're going to make ends meet and who don't honor their word because you're an energetic match for them. You got to look at debt. And I did a cool live. And for those of you in Crack Your Money Codes, I have a money codes program. Incredible. I'm constantly adding it. So every time I ask, I'm going to do something around that. But I actually did a live about it. And I think it's in here. I'll post it again, maybe in this masterclass. You can look at it, but you got to look at it as like, this was an investment. And hey, if I'm an energetic match for 80K, then I'm also an energetic match to receive 80K. Like, we got to shift this, and you got to shift debt into investment. But this whole takes a long time. Not only do you continue to attract that storyline, but the way you act, the decisions you make, how you make your decisions in alignment with that frequency is why it takes a long time. You got to start shifting that. And I have something going to be launching tomorrow. And so I'm going to be also, like I said, I'm going to be launching a new membership. If you're an inner circle, you get it all, but it's going to be a membership that's going to be $111. Pay as you go, no commitment. Immediately, you'll get access to a bunch of programs and master classes that you can binge and then you can leave. But every month, I'm going to be creating something like this. It's going to be a training. And the first one's going to be called Collapsing Time. And this can be applicable to anything, money, sales, whatever it is, whatever results you want to have. I'm going to teach you the strategies, the identity, the tacticals for collapsing time. I'm going to be launching it tomorrow. And if you want to buy it separately, it's $111. Or you do the membership where you get a bunch of stuff plus that and the new things coming, because there's a whole bunch of things coming. It will be lifetime access, and it'll be a membership that I'll do. It'll be a one-day thing, collapsing time. So I said you can buy it. Yes, I'm going to give you guys details. The only details I'll give you right now is that it will be pay as you go. It's going to be $111. That's it. You can buy it in full for a year, which you'll save $300. So it's $1,111 you pay full year, but then you get a lifetime, you get a program with it, like a live program, like Goddess Code, Coach Academy, like you get to pick whatever program you want to do live with me. But then you're going to get every month a training around a really big concept in my world. And immediately you get access to like Crack Your Money Codes, like different masterclasses I've done that I took an off. You'll get, oh my God, what else is in there? The Art of Feminine Magnetism. These are all worth like $1,000. So you jump in for $111, you get a live training with me once a month, you get to binge programs, and it's pay as you go, not commitment. I want to make sure my business is accessible for everybody. Whether you want to do Inner Circle, where you do every live program, every masterclass, everything, because Inner Circle is also going to get mastermind calls with me. So for those of you Inner Circle, stay tuned. There's a lot of things coming. In Inner Circle, you get everything excluded for masterminds, but you get a discount for masterminds, which is great. But I will be launching it. I'll tell you what it is. It's called the We Go First membership. It's extraordinary. It's going to be incredible. But what I'm going to be launching tomorrow is Collapsing Time. So if you do that, if you buy that separately and you want to go in the membership, I'll just credit you and you'll get to go in the membership. If you just want to buy it separately, you want to learn the art of collapsing time around your results. And this is applicable to anything. So I'll give you the identity, the mindset, and strategies. That's going to be starting, I haven't picked the date, but it's probably like the second week of September. Maybe the first week, we'll see. But it's $111 lifetime access. And you'll see me launch it tomorrow. And if you decide to buy that and you want to do the membership, you can move over. I got you all. There will be more details coming, but I really want to focus on this masterclass. But it's extraordinary. Like it's cool. A lot of people always get worried about leaning back. But when I lean back in the summer, it's like the downloads and the breakthroughs are out of this world. So, and also then if you ever want to move into Inner Circle and you want to do all the live programs and have mastermind calls with me, I will take off the money that you've invested completely and you'll get to use it towards there. So it's amazing. It's a win-win-win. It's a no-brainer. More details will come. So for today's call, this is your homework. We're going to wrap it up. Tomorrow we are morphing. Tomorrow we're going to talk tactics and strategies. We're going to reinvent yourself. I have incredible contemplations for you so you can really tap in. What's my soul want? What's this identity that I want? Remember these, I got to read these back after. This is amazing. I'm in bed. I'm so happy. I made a huge discovery, a big reason that I'm not good enough and feeling not fitting in was because I was taking out of second and put into first grade when I was little. See what I mean? And so for me, Dana, it was the same thing because I was in ESL and it was already so scary to be an immigrant. It's like, and one teacher really messed me up too. She told me I was stupid because it was hard for me to like grasp something. And so think about what that does to you. Like it's wild what happens, guys, but these stories are not you. Like we are born incredible. We are born extraordinary. There's nothing wrong with us. It's all of a sudden people brainwashing us with all of their stuff. It's like we have viruses in our brain. And so tomorrow we're going to start upgrading. Love this call. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. And I have contemplation. So in the guide section, I'm going to be posting homework. 111 comments, guys. Okay. Let me finish this. And then I'm going to read comments later. I got a plot twist happening behind the scenes. Can you please throw in body code? Yes, I'm going to throw in body code. So literally you're going to get like $10,000, $15,000 worth of my lifetime access programs. So you don't get the live programs like Goddess Code, Badass Mode, Coach Academy. That's for Inner Circle. And they're coming all with mastermind calls. So we get to do Q&A. But well, like I said, if you buy the We Go First membership for $1,111, you're going to save $220. But then you get to pick any of my live programs. So whether you want to do Coach Academy, you want to do Goddess Code. And then, like I said, if you decide you want to move from the We Go First membership and you want to move into Inner Circle, you will take off that amount. Okay. And so for those of you in Inner Circle, you have no idea how much I needed this call today. I'm so happy. And please share, guys. So here's the other thing. The 50% tuition credit, if you guys share throughout this masterclass, you'll be put in that. I'll probably draw more than five people, let's be honest. But the only thing you can't use is towards the membership, but you can use it towards programs, okay? You can use it towards actual programs. So if you just wanted to buy a program or a code or something like that, it's 50% off. But please share. It's like for people who just need this work. Oh my gosh, I never thought of that line. Tag people. I love you guys so much. Okay, so let's wrap this up. I'm going to give you guys homework. So first homework is just become aware. This is step one, okay? What's your story? What are the limiting stories that you have? What, not even just about yourself, about people, about the economy. What are you continually validating? It's too hard. Look at all that. I'm going to give you homework, okay? And here's the other thing I want you to do. So I'm going to also give you a piece about shadow work. Okay. So we all have shadows. Everybody got shadows. I'll share more of my shadows with you as we go deeper in my programs. But there are three ways to cast some light on your shadows, because these are the other things that hold us back. You know, your little habits, little addictions, the things that you're afraid of people knowing. The way I want you to look at this is this way. So the ways that we look at shadows is, where are you suppressing? Where do you have things you're escaping from? So there's suppression, escapism, and then there's projections. And I'll explain what they are. So look, where are you suppressing any negative feelings, negative habits, things you don't want to face, things you don't want to look at? You're just kind of pushing it all down. The other place to look at is, where are you practicing escapism? So you don't want to sit with uncomfortable emotions. There's a problem you're not dealing with. So escapism looks like this. So suppression is really just like, it's not there. I pretend it's not there. I push it down. Escapism is like, you don't want to deal with uncomfortable feelings, so you reach for external things to distract you. Escapism is literally almost this. It's like also things like as small as you being bored. So when you're bored, what do you do to escape that? Do you smoke? Do you drink? Do you scroll a lot? So escapism looks like gaming a lot, shopping a lot, drinking, smoking, drugs, binging, scrolling. Those are you escaping something. So I want you to look at, what are you escaping? So before you reach for the thing you're escaping, like before you go gaming or shopping, what is it that I don't want to face? What's the problem? What's the uncomfortable feelings? What's the habit? What's the addiction? What is it? Notice where you're using external things to avoid uncomfortable things. What are you running away from? Okay. Then the other place is to look at, where are you projecting on other people? When you're really stressed, you freak out on your partners, your kids, you lash out on people. So other places to look at projections is, where are you gossiping? Where are you involved? Even in celebrity gossip, that's you not wanting the spotlight on you. So it's like, let me put a spotlight on something else. So where are you gossiping? Where are you involved in drama? Do you know where else people don't look at projections, but obsessions with reality TV? It's a form of projection. People don't realize this, because it's like, I don't want to face my own shit, so let me go and put the spotlight on reality TV. Like, look, let's look at other people's drama, you know? Projection is honestly, or is why cancel culture exists. It's like, the same thing you're dealing with, people will try to cancel another person for doing. But really, when people try to cancel somebody else out, is because they're literally doing the exact same thing, the thing that they want to avoid. You know, when we remember back in the day, the angry mobs, which I feel like still exist today, like the angry mobs, that's a form of projection. It's like, let me go put a spotlight on somebody else. Let's bring the torches, the angry mob, because we don't want the spotlight on ourselves for the past things we have done, or the past things, or the things that we're looking at. It's constantly projecting a spotlight on somebody else when we just start looking at ourselves. Okay. So look at where you're suppressing, escaping, and where you're projecting. These are your shadows, and we all have them. There's no shame about them. It's okay. So today's call, just notice, just bring awareness. And then you can ask yourself questions. Well, are these limiting stories, all these stories creating a narrative I like right now? Maybe I'm going to start to put this down for a bit. And then tomorrow we will start to try on new identities. I'm going to really help you figure out what your soul is really calling. Another great place to figure that out, and I'll talk about it, I do have a human design program too. So like, you want to look at your purpose and cross, and I do human design readings, and I actually have a new thing. I'm going to call it like purpose readings, and it will be looking at your cross and your gates to really see what you're doing. I have the left angle cross of prevention. It's literally to correct people's behaviors, extremes, and put them on the right path. So I'll share about that tomorrow. So I'm going to put this in the guide section. You guys will have some homework, but just start looking at it. Just start looking at it, and then look at where you're avoiding, where you're numbing out, where you're projecting. It's the things you don't want to look at, but we got to shift out of that. We're going on a hero's journey, and we got to let go of the things that are weighing back. We want the air balloon to go up in the sky. We got to let go of the, we got to let go of sandbags. Tell me more about purpose reading. So if you're in the human design programs, they're only 222 for you. If you want to do one with me, you haven't done the human design program, they're $444. They're 90 minutes with a 30-minute follow-up call. And we are diving into literally like your actual cross. We're going to look at your profile as well, the role you're here to do. We'll look at all of that, but I want to look at specifically your cross, because the four gates that you have in your cross make up 70% of your personality. And I want to really help you tap into that and how you're supposed to do that. If you actually look at my programs and understand my cross, yeah, this is why I do this work. And so those will be coming. And you can always reach out for those. I did a lot of human design readings, mostly for 5-1s. I'm like a magnet for them. The leaders, let's go, let's move. We're here to shift people. But they're extraordinary. If you're already in the human design program, you get that half off. That's the best part. But for those of you going to do the We Go First membership with me, there'll be human design stuff in there. And here's the thing, in my memberships, in my world, once you're in my world, you will always get all kinds of different discounts as well. So win, 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 win. It's going to be amazing. And you can use the 50% tuition actually towards a human design reading. If you just want a human design reading that's basic, if you want to have a purpose reading, you can use that towards there too. Okay. So the only thing we can't use it for is masterminds, private coaching, and the membership, because it's already got a lot of discounts in there. But otherwise, yeah, this is amazing. I know my type strategy profile perfectly. Yeah. Now we want to lurk our gates. Your memberships, are they held on Facebook or separate platform? They're on Facebook, but not everybody's in Facebook. So what happens is you will be part of on my, you'll be on an email list. So you can be on the Zooms, but you will be getting all the YouTube links is what you'll get. So I do love if you're in the groups, it's amazing, but not everybody likes the Facebook. There are some people that don't want to be in a group environment. So what happens is once the calls are done, they're transferred into a YouTube link and you get the homework and YouTube link sent to your email. But I love doing it on a Facebook group. I think these containers show us a lot. And honestly, the more you're around people doing this work, and we'll talk a lot about how our environment like really impacts us. It's extraordinary when you're in an environment where everybody's doing the work and they're really focusing on themselves, because it is really hard to change in our personal life when everybody around us is like impending doom and, you know, doing the opposite of what we're doing. But when you're in my world and every month we are moving, we are growing, you're like, you're my membership. You'll have time to ask questions. You do inner circle. You'll get to literally do mastermind calls with me too. Like I got you. We're going to shift. Our environment impacts us a lot, but I will talk more about that tomorrow. So I love you. Share, tag. I will see you tomorrow. Our call tomorrow is at 111. So That's Eastern Standard Time, Toronto time. I love you. Thank you for being here. I'm going to post some homework for you guys. Do this work. It's life changing. And like, you know, I'm going to be start going into the season of emotional intelligence. There'll be other master classes. We're going to start moving into Goddess Code in October. I really want to focus for this September a lot around our identity. And there's going to be different codes I'm going to be dropping. Like I said, collapsing time. I'm dropping that next week. This is going to help you start moving. And here's the thing with collapsing time. When you start getting results, it boosts your confidence. So that's one identity we're going to work on a lot. See you guys tomorrow. Okay. I love you so much. Thank you so much for being here. I'll catch up on your comments. I hope you guys have a beautiful, beautiful day. And I cannot wait for tomorrow. Thank you guys. Bye.